This is Shomik Banerjee from Dakshin Jogoddol, Rajpur. I express my gratitude to the organizers of this program for giving me the chance to participate in it. The area I live in is under the jurisdiction of Sonarpur Police Station in South 24 Parganas. Our family, the Banerjee family of Dakshin Jogoddol, has been living here for almost six generations, approximately since 1880s. However, in this brief session, I am going to show you some wonderful works of embroidery done by my grandmother, late Durgarani Banerjee. She died in 2013 in the age of almost 84, and she got married to my grandfather, late Shochindranath Banerjee, in 1942 or 43 at the age of almost 13. In spite of her willingness to go to school, she never got the chance to have formal school education in her life, but she learned to read and write from her mother. Durgarani Banerjee was a voracious reader. She was an occasional writer. She involved herself in various social works. She presided over the women's association in the nearby club, etc. And she did some wonderful works of embroidery, perhaps between 1950s to 1960s. I am going to show you the works which are almost 60 or 70 years old. We all know that Kantha stitch is a conventional and traditional form of embroidery which originated and flourished in Bengal. But interestingly, the works I am going to show you are completely different from Kantha stitch. This is a landscape which was made by Durgarani Banerjee only with needle and threads of different colors on a piece of cloth. And she used Kashmiri stitch, satin stitch, chain stitch while developing this work. And look how the threads are woven, keeping in mind the rhythm of nature. The threads of river are woven from this side to this side, the threads of valley from these to these, the threads of mountain from these to these. So this is a wonderful work of art, and it resembles more with a painted canvas than a conventional work of embroidery. And she avoided doing or developing the conventional designs of embroidery and family designs. This is the two birds. Two birds are engaged in amorous conversation. And look at the surrounding, the leaves, the flowers, the different shades of green in the leaves and the petals of the flowers, the figures of these birds. This is very naturalistic. And I think that her approach to art was very naturalistic in nature. And look at this bunch of flowers, how beautifully color is chosen, and the variety of colors, the contrast of colors, the leaves, and the entire composition. It is a wonderful work. And apart from these works, which have chosen themes from nature, the birds, the flowers, the landscape, I'm going to show you something different from that. This is from the story, the famous story of the two jackals, which we call in Bengali, Angur Paltok, the grapes are sour. The two jackals are really looking at the vineyard. So this is from a story. These are remarkable work I'm going to show you. This is from Shakuntala, perhaps from Mahabharata or Kalidas' famous play. Shakuntala is feeding the deer. This is a wonderful work. Look at the figure of Shakuntala. Look at the movement of the deer. Everything is done. The flowers, the trees, and the entire atmosphere. And this picture, this painting perhaps, symbolizes the interaction between man and nature. For three reasons, all these works become very important for me. First, Durgarani Banerjee never showed likeness for the conventional art form of Kantha stitch, though she led the conventional life of a wife in a very conservative family. And I think that her choice for Kashmiri stitch, satin stitch or chain stitch accounts for a liberal outlook, a desire to overcome any regionalist approach in art form. Second, she showed much courage in choosing various themes from natural scenes to mythical stories or characters. And third, and most importantly, I think, embroidery, a piece of work with threads and needles on a piece of cloth, gives her a promise for permanence. Through these works, she perhaps wanted to establish a conversation with posterity in creative terms, because we know that a work of embroidery is more durable than a painting on paper. And I consider these works as a most valuable addition to my family heritage. I end my presentation by giving thanks to my uncle, Mr. Rupak Banerjee, for taking much toil in preserving these works for future generations. Thank you all.